Hello student, good afternoon. Hope you all safe. Today onwards we start our the new topic that related to the crops and its IPM strategy. So let us see the first one, the integrated pest management of cotton. So student, before starting up our lecture, so what is the contribution of cotton in whole country? So this is the introductory part of this cotton crop. So already you know well that studied in agronomy that cotton is the fiber crop and it is the backbone of textile industries. And the India occupies the largest area in the world under cotton, and it is ranked about in third in overall production. Even also in Maharashtra, the cotton growing area are the Marathwada and some part of Vidarbha region. And in our country, it's contribute 7% of GDP. So only in the cotton crop. So that more contribution about this cotton, and also its employment point of view, it provide many employment near about 60 million people in India that depend on cotton. So again, about this, the world fiber need point of view, the cotton made the 45% of fiber in world. In case of this edible oil point of view, the 10% of world edible oil is obtained through cotton. About the insect pest, in whole world, the more than 1,326 species that reported that attacking on cotton. And however, in India, near about 1,662 species have been reported. Okay, so student, so let us see about this pest that already that studied in your second semester course of different crop pest. But today we are going to talk and discuss about some pest, its a nature of damage in shortly, and its a integrated pest management strategy we learn today lecture. So first of all, the cotton pest are classified in three categories that mostly that very severe pest that commonly called as of three types of bollworms, that American bollworm, spotted bollworm, and cotton pink bollworm. These are the three important bollworm complex. And some sucking pest also that attack on cotton. So these are all this polyphagous pest, namely leafhopper or jacid. Even also the some aphid, mealybugs, thrips, and red cotton bug and dusky cotton bug that comes under in suckers. Some depollutors also that attack on cotton crop, some like the black cutworms, like some leaf roller, grasshopper, green semi looper, and tobacco cutworm. Even also the some leaf folder also that attacks on cotton. So these are the three important some pest that bollworms, suckers, and depollutors. So the starting from the bollworm complex, the first one is the fruit and boll feeders. The first fruit borer that called as a American bollworm, its scientific name is given on slide, Helicorpa armigera. I'm shortly that discuss and that talking about this nature of damage. Here we can see the picture that I'm showing you, that this one here, that larva that enter inside the boll, this one. So here the regular holes, circular holes that create by this insect, this larva, and some part that enter inside the boll and start the feeding internal content. So this is one of the some symptoms or identification marks of this insect Helicorpa armigera. After the feeding, the larva seen on the boll, and due to the boll that continuously feed, trusting their heads alone inside. So it's a Helicorpa armigera. Now the second one, it's a pink bollworm. This one, this pink bollworm, when this attack on vegetative state, mostly on that flowering stage. So during that period, the flowers becomes a rose like appearance, that is called as the rosetted flowers. And after this attack continuously occur till picking, so it's form double seed formation. This is one we can see here on picture, the pink bollworm. So after that, this whole bowls are discolored. The fiber quality that is called as a discolored lint. Even also the if we for proper identification of this pink bollworm, we can observe through this the excreta when this that enter inside. So that's called as the holes of entry plugged by excreta. This is also the identification marks by pink bollworm. If in case of this pink bollworm that attack on vegetative stage, so during that formation of these squares and the bowls, so that means the immature bowls are drop off. These are the some symptoms caused by pink bollworm. Now third, that bollworms called as a spotted bollworm. This is when the adult of the spotted bollworms, namely ERS vitella. Again, it has one more species, ERS insulana, but I'm not mentioned on that slide. So it's one single species, ERS vitella. This here the picture I'm showing you, flat square bores or holes and rotting, that symptoms caused by this ERS vitella. So these symptoms are flat square, shedding of the squares and young bowls, and also that holes on bowls, and finally continuously if attacking of this cotton crop. So here the rottening of bowls occur by this spotted bollworm. Now these are some suckers pest, namely leafhopper, that called as a jacid, Amarasca bigitula bigitula. It's a scientific name. Here we can picture and see that this jacid. This jacid are when suck the plant parts, mostly on the leaves, start the curling downwards, and finally this continuously infestation if that occur. So here the reddening plants, and finally the called as a hopper burn symptoms. And this type of the symptoms if severe, so whole plant leaves are dried up and shedding start. So that is the nature of damage by this jacid. Now let us see about the cotton aphid. This is also the one second most plant sucker insect. It's also called as the plant lice. Okay, so this same that curling and crinkling type of the damage occur due to this suckers type of mouth parts. But here one major symptoms caused by this aphid than leafhopper, during the sucking of this plant sap, so it's a secret one like honeydew. So called as this honeydew is to develop the black sooty mold. Why this black sooty mold is very very severe fungus? Why? Because due to this the development of this black sooty mold, so here the photosynthesis is totally affected. So finally what, the further growth of this cotton is arrested. So that's why this is the very severe pest of this sucking insect. So now let us see the third one, thrips. So this thrips is also the sucking type of insect. When this the insect that suck the sap, so that a silvery shine and shriveling type of the symptoms caused on the plants. Whitefly, it's a Bemisia tabaci. This insect also that is more number and more population incidence when occur. So there is the formation of leaf curl virus. Okay, now the next, red cotton bug. This is also the last stage of the picking of a cotton crop. That time this red cotton bug insect are attacking. So this is the red stained lint and rottening of bolls, and even also that turn dark brown by the infestation of these young bolls. So that type of the nature of damage caused by this red cotton bug. Now the last one is the six mealybugs. This mealybugs also the very severe pest. Its appearance as a cottony appearance on plants. So this plant sucker insect mealybugs are affected the plant, and it's appear as a sick. That whole plant is appear as a sick, and resulted this population if severe, so reduce the fruiting capacity. It means that the bowl formation is totally affected through this the mealybugs insect. So now we'll start our the integrated pest management practices in cotton crop. Here we can see that one field of cotton. So here that one like plastic type one pheromone trap were installed. And second picture here, one stick, and here that attached with one blue sticky trap. So these two tools are important to monitor the insect incidence. How? So generally, what if the farmers not properly taking the observation of this pest, so it's never that to control the pest of a further incidence. How? So that's why the monitoring is very important to assess, to estimate the incidence of insect pest by using the use the pheromone traps. Suppose in case to check the population of bollworm complex, so we have to install 5 traps per hectare. So we can count the number of this bollworm adult, and we can set up the decision, we can set up the management strategy on the basis of this population. We take the decision, and finally we can use the different control measure. That's why the monitoring is important. Same as in case of the sucking insect, whitefly, jacid, thrips, and aphid purpose, we can install this at the rate of 25 sucking pest control point of view. The yellow sticky trap or blue sticky trap we can install, and to properly monitor the suckers and bollworms. Now, second one, the cultural methods. So already we learned in previous lecture different types of tools of IPM. The first one is the control, cultural control. So this is a cultural control. Here the farmers that are deep flowing that are doing here in field. Second one, that here the some farmers that weeding operation, land preparation operation that are doing. So this is that why it's important. What may be the after the harvesting of previous crop, those are the hibernating stages are hidden inside the stubbles, even also the soil. So this all that through this the cultural practices, the deeply flowing when occur. So resting stage like a larva, adult, and the eggs are exposed. So other vertebrates like abiotic, biotic factors that affect and to control the next generation. So that's the second one is the clean cultivation that's used to destruct the crop residues, even the fallen squares and some boles. Avoid here that mention I am that here the third practice in case of the cultural control, the avoid the nitrogenous fertilizer. How? Because of however these different types of the suckers when attacking or incident started. So this nitrogenous fertilizer that gives the vigorous growth. Okay. So how? So same time, if these the plants are that attractive color, so there is the chances to some plant suckers like the aphid, jacid. Okay. So that's why during the reproductive stage, we have to avoid this nitrogenous fertilizer. So here that one woman that applying the nitrogenous fertilizer application. So it's one some simple picture I'm showing you. Now the next one. So here again some practices that given in cultural control. Use of resistant varieties. How? So we learned in the host plant resistance, if that growing the resistant variety, there is just no chances to attacking of the pest. Even also that to planting of trap crop in case of the okra. Okay, if the some like uprooting and burning when the larval population reaches its peak, so we can reduce the infestation. Again here, do not extend the crop period, so there is a chances to bollworm complex that will attack. Here they're growing early maturing varieties that we can easily get more early in production through this the growing variety. Use of acid dilantin seeds, so there is a chances no chances to attacking of this pink bollworm. So that due to the soak in the concentrated sulfuric acid near about the dose about the 80 to 100 ml per kg seed at 2 to 3 minutes. Wash it properly with water for 2 to 3 times, followed by this washing with the lime superannuated and shade dry, and then we have to use for the sowing purpose. Now the next one, mechanical control. This mechanical control also the second practices that used in the IPM management of cotton. Here that hand picking practice, what may be the that the larva or the eggs that occur on the plant parts, we have to collect through manually and destroy that various insect stages by this affected plant, or some like the destruction of plant debris and we can also that use the traps before the swim. Even also that set up some pheromone traps already we learned in previous that of methods. So at the rate of 10 per hectare for monitoring the each year, and timely that spray that against used to bollworm. Now set up the bird perches here. This bird is very important to vertebrate to control to pick up this all larvae eggs through this bird. So that is the set up the bird perches. Even also that we can use the some different trap crop castor for the use to against the Spodoptera litura spotted bollworm known as that even also the some like marigold also that use. So why this marigold castor that use? So marigold for the American bollworm, that is the Helicorpa armigera, okra, that spotted bollworm, castor. So why this all adults that attract towards that crop and that start the egg laying, that called as the oviposition, called as oviposition. So known as that too, we can easily control the further population. Even also that keep 10 to 15 pheromone traps, and in case of the suckers, plant sucker insect, we have to install or that fix yellow or blue sticky trap, yellow that mostly jacinth and aphid, and blue for generally used for the thrips. Now the biological control agent of the next IPM practices in case of the cotton. Here I am showing you the picture. This one trichocard that fix in the cotton field, and here this on trichocard. These eggs are smeared here, that all eggs. Okay, so here that mention on the trichogramma that chilon is 1.5 lakh per hectare these eggs. So why these are the important to manage the pest of bollworm, and this adult when that emerge out from this trichocard, it's lay the eggs on host of bollworm. So through the oviposition, the further infestation of this bollworm are totally reduced, that known as this biological control. Even also the other parasitoid also that use generally Chelonis blackburni, even also the Telenomus remus, also Brachon inhibitor, Brachon species also that used to different lepidopteran pest of cotton. Even some are the predators also used to controlling the pest like Chrysoprola carnea. At the rate of 50,000 per hectare, its grubs that we have to release and control the different suckers insect. Here some biological control for the biopesticide HNPV is nothing but Helicorpa armigera nuclear polyhydrosis virus, or SLNPV Spodoptera litura nuclear polyhydrosis virus. These are the two biopesticide, that viral biopesticide used against HNPV, used against American bollworm, and SLNPV used against the spotted bollworm. At the rate of 250 liter per hectare, if we applied to manage the pest larva of bollworm in that initial condition. Even also that bacterial application, we can use that BT at the rate of 1 kg per hectare, and against some botanical pesticide also used in biological control, that is use of neem based product, that azadirachtin, where that one active ingredient agent that control the initial stages of the larva, eggs and adults through this biological control. Now the last one is a chemical control. This is the last practices generally used in IPM. So why, whatever the need base, suppose in case no need that pesticide, so no generally that used by this, but why the farmers directly use the chemical, so that's where there is the chances to resistance and resurgence or development in case of the pest. That's where the more abundant and that outbreaks occur. So here in IPM in cotton, that gives the last methods of chemical control, so known as need based use of insecticide. Suppose in case the ETL is 10% of pink bollworm infected that flowers in particular, so that's time we can use like the quinolphos or chloroporifos at the rate of 2 ml per liter, and we have to maintain the interval at near about 10 to 15 days. We have to maintain the interval, and then we can use the further pesticide. In case of the severe incidents occur, then we have to change the pesticide. So why alternate use of the pesticide is recommended? So there is no chances to development of resistance, even also the some resurgence. So here in severe incidence, cypermethrin pesticide here mentioned on slide, with the rate of 2 ml per liter, even lambda cyhalothrin also that available. Here the rate is very less than cypermethrin, 1.5 ml per liter. Again, we that mentioned, I mentioned on that slide, many insecticide. And during the examination point of view, you can use 2 or 3 pesticide. And last one here, the foliar spray of this against the different insect like suckers, we use imidacloprid 0.4 ml per liter, methyl dimetone 2 ml per liter, and monocrotophos also, that it is one highly toxic chemical. So generally avoid this pesticide. So try to need based pesticide. So this all pesticide that apply at the rate at the interval of 15 days and 30 days after sowing for this sucking pest. But generally what is also cotton seed are already that treated with imidacloprid. So near about 40 to 45 days after sowing, then required the different type of the insecticide. So dear student, these are the whole information of integrated pest management of cotton. So try to read about this whole. Okay, thank you.